Vishnupadaya Krishna Prasaya Bhutale Sri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine
Thank you. good. We form something. Two lines go down and two lines high. Then it will be more sweet. Can you do like this? First down and then two
up.
Up.
I don't know.
Like you should do Kirtan, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, in the same line, you should do. Hare Krishna in this tune.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare
Rama, Hare Rama.
Go down some. Again. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Krishna Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna.
Open your hand. You should do. Not like. You should do.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Gaur Praman.
Nande Hari Hari Bol.
You can? Here? How you jumped here?
By the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
Oh, you jumped? In the senior seats of Devar.
Yes.
Although you should not jump, others, you should have the honor for superiors. No? Yes, we should learn to give respect to senior devotees of Swamiji. So you should go there and here. Understand me? Now there and then. You have any question? Now you should go and give. Oh, there are so many seniors. Like they are, I honor them, but they are so humble that they are sitting here. You should be humble so much and give so much honor to seniors. Then you can go up. You should learn, all should learn. At the time of taking prasadam, at the time of also kirtan, at the time of sitting anywhere, we should try to always give honor to all. In the morning, when we are doing parikrama, senior should go forward and junior gradually, not to disturb anyone, not to disturb. Always keeping onward. If you are not giving honor and you are not humble, you cannot progress. Junior should also give honor, and seniors They will teach them with, like son, like younger brother, with love and affection. But they should be taught all these rules and regulations. Always try to respect seniors, always. But seniors should see also that if anyone being shishya of shishya, but he has so much in what? No. If he is qualified, he has given all his worldly things, and he knows all the transcendental truths, practicing bhakti yoga, and he is serving so much Vaishnava and Guru, then he should also respect him. Always. Not guided him. In this way, we can increase all these things. You know, Swamiji preached everywhere in world. See, Pujjapa Siddhar Maharaj was sitting in Navadvip. And how he used to give him honor, you know? Now disciples perhaps not knowing, because they are concealing these facts. He has so much honor for my Gurudev. So much. To his seniors, always. Like Siksha Guru. Like I honor my God brothers, like my Siksha Guru, to become Maharaj, Bhaman Maharaj, to others, they are his seniors. They respect so much, but I always so, Pujjapa Swami Maharaj was in the line of Vaishnava, Guru. So he must respect, he used to give respect to Pujjapa Siddhar Maharaj, Bhakti Vilastit Maharaj, and all others. So we should know all the etiquettes. This is Vaishnava etiquette.
Agyana Simirandasya Gyananjana Shalakya Chakshurun Militangina Tasmai Sigurave Vancha Kalpatarubhasya कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनाम्ने गौर गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जिहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वो विनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमां तवैवास्मि न जिगामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञैराधे त्वं नयमा
You know, Sanatana Goswami, also you have perhaps heard the name of Jagadananda Prabhu. Jagadananda Prabhu, from boyhood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was in Navadvip Leela also. And he was like Satyabhama, having some man. So, Sanatana Goswami was the Prime Minister of any Muslim king, and he was so intelligent, learner of all Shastra. In Puri once he came, and then he met with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then he returned to Vrindavan. Jagadananda was there.
He wanted to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, he wanted to serve so much. Sometimes he brought, anyone brought a vessel, full pot of very fragrant Ayurveda oil. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sometimes he used to faint in Krishna consciousness. So he brought with great care. He gave it to Govinda that, oh, yes, put on the head of Mahaprabhu some oil tea. Then Govinda told to Mahaprabhu that Jagadananda has ordered me to give put some oil on your face. This is Ayurvedic, very powerful, like medicine. Mahaprabhu told very humbly that take this oil to Jagannath temple and give it to for Deepak, for lamp. So he could not put the oil on the head of Mahaprabhu. Next day, Jagadananda asked to Govinda that, have you put this oil on his head? He told that, I could not. Why? Oh, he ordered me to give this oil to Jagannath. And by thus, I will have that thing. He became very upset. And he took that oil pot and in the front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he smashed. And all water, oil was here and there. And he became so angry. And he went from there. He went to his bhajan koti and he locked the door. How are you, can you say? Locked. Anyhow, one day, 2 days, he was crying, but not coming to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu thinking that, he has some anger to me because I am not accepted, and that is why he has that. One day, third day, then he, on fourth day in morning, he went and he knocked the door. Oh Jagadananda. But he was not replying, only weeping. Mahaprabhu told that, for 3 days I have not taken anything. Empty stomach. And now I am so much hungry. I am going to take bath in ocean. And very soon I am coming. Be prepared all kinds of preparations for me. And telling him, went away. And he went to sea and took bath. And he again returned after 1 hour. In the meantime, Jagadananda, he took bath, changed his clothes, and then began to prepare so many kinds of vegetables, rice, dal, chapati, and so many things. Various. In chutney of tamarind, let's so many things. About more than 56 more than. And he brought a very big banana leaf, 2-3. And he preparation. Govinda was with Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told, he requested Govinda that tell Mahaprabhu to take prasadam. Mahaprabhu told that, I cannot take. Oh, there should be 2 seeds and 2 leaves. And I will sit with Jagadananda. And we will take prasadam together. And if he is not taking, then I am going. Empty stomach. Then Jagadananda told to, not directly telling to Mahaprabhu, not direct talk. He told to Govinda, Govinda tell Mahaprabhu that he should take gladly, and after that, when he will finish, oh, then we will both take together remnant of Mahaprabhu. Then he told to Mahaprabhu, you should take, he will take after you. So only remnant he will take. Then Mahaprabhu took prasadam. And then after that, oh, that remnant was divided into two, and it don't know. Then he became happy, but he was not coming directly to speak Mahaprabhu anything. Even there was some smell of man. He went again after 2-3 days to Mahaprabhu and told that, I am going to Vrindavan. Please order me. I want your permission. Mahaprabhu said, why you are going? Oh, for so many long time I wanted to go with you, but you could not take me with you. So now I want to go and to take darshan. I want to be there and to serve Radha Krishna Kanyuga. Mahaprabhu told, you can go, but not for long time. Go and see and return back. Don't climb on the top of Govardhan. You are not qualified to be there. You can quarrel there. You can see the rules and regulations. Yeah, Brajvasi is not taking bath or what he is doing. So then you will judge according to your mentality. So you make some offenses. So don't be there. You should return back. He went anyhow. But when he left Puri, and he came to border under a tree, then he was lamenting so much. Oh, why I did so mistake? I cannot be life without Mahaprabhu. I have done wrong. Should I go return? But how can I return? Then what will I answer? And he was in dilemma. What to do, not to do. One day, 2 days, he was there, weeping. Anyhow, he consoled his mind. Anyhow, I should go. Then he went to Vrindavan. And he met Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami told that you should be here and see with me all the pastime places. One day, Sanatana Goswami was out of his bhajan kuti and he was cooking. He never took any madhukari. But I am not qualified for madhukari. Sanatana Goswami, Rup Goswami, they are qualified. I cannot digest. We cannot digest madhukari. We are not qualified. So he was there and cooking. And what became? Sanatana Goswami took any saffron cloth from anyone. And he did like this. And he returned. Then he was cooking. And the pot was one on fire. Stove. It was so hot. It was khichdi. It was doing takbak. Takbak, you know? Why? So Sanatana Goswami, he asked Sanatana Goswami, you are very faithful to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From where is this collector, this cloth of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? He told simply that it is not of Mahaprabhu, it is of any Mayavadi here. And he gave me and I do. Oh, of Mayavadi, he at once took that pot and he then Sanatana Goswami became very humble and he was just smiling and telling, I was testing you. I know that you have so much faith on Mahaprabhu. so much fire. And you cannot bear any others, the saffron cloth of Mayavadi. You are so attached to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu rebukes you. What is it meaning? He loves you so much. So he gives you madhurya ras of rebuking. And to me, Sanatan Goswami told, oh, he said, oh, Sanatan Goswami is so honorable person. He is so high class of devotee. He is superior to all. So this is like Nimbaras. Nimbaras, the juice of Nimbaras. One Sanatan Goswami was in, again, in Puri. And Sanatan Goswami was telling himself that I'm so low, I'm so wretched person. He has some itches coming in the way, some mosquitoes has gotten, so much juice from his body was coming. Pash, very bad smelling. And Mahaprabhu, what he used to do? To embrace him. And Sanatan Goswami would say, don't touch Prabhu, don't touch Prabhu. But here. Then Sanatan Goswami met with Jagdananda and told, what should I do? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always wants to embrace me, and I'm so wretched, and this disease, and what coming? What's coming, and Mahaprabhu touches me. What should I do? Should I return to Vrindavan? Yes, you should go to Vrindavan. Don't be here. Otherwise, Mahaprabhu will touch you and he may have some disease, so you should quickly go. Mahaprabhu heard this and told to Jagadan, oh, Jagai, you are a boy of only 2 days and you are being instructor of Sanatan Goswami. How he is superior, and you have dared to give some intelligence and advice. Don't think you like that you are so of 2 days only, boy only, having no intelligence. He gave that. We should honor, especially those who are pure devotees, they should be humble and try to give honor. This is only way to progress in Krishna consciousness. Now we should come to our point. Oh, now it is 7. Come to with me in Vrindavan or Mathura. Be concentrate your minds, no? You know that all the human beings in the whole world, even you are in America, the richest person now it is in the whole world. And you are making so much money. Your house is full of all kinds of comforts and everything. Very, very beautiful wife you have. And when she becomes of 1 year, 2 years, you can divorce and again you pick up. And very good children qualify. Everything is okay. Having 2, 3, 4, 5 dogs, no harm. But even there are so many problems. All are suffering. Especially those who are rich, more suffering than in world. So in this world, anyone is not happy. And this life is full of miseries, problems, difficulties, sorrow, suffering. coldness also, and so many things. Rogues, full of rogues, diseases. In this world there is none who has never tested any kinds of suffering, sorrows or problems. I think among you there are so many rich persons. But any of you can raise hand that I have never had any problem without problem and I am always all time I am happy. Can anyone tell? Oh, today morning you are telling that I am sick. I remember. So in this world there are none. Whether he can be king, prime minister, president or anything. Only if there is any devotee surrendered to Krishna, he may be happy. But he will tell, I am not happy. He never will tell. What he will tell? Oh, very big problem. Why I am alive? Why I am not dying? Because I have no darshan of Krishna. So in this world, anyone is not happy. So all the jivas, they want happiness. There are so many sufferings, problems in this world, and all are unhappy. That is why all want pure happiness. But it is absurd in this Maya Sansara, in this material world, anyone can have happiness. That is why all the Vedas has told, Sukham me bhuyat, Dukham me ma bhuta. All the Vedas are telling that we should always be happy. Always happiness comes to me. And suffering should not come. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, Karmanya Rahmananam Dukhattai Sukhayaja. Pashet pakam viparyasam mithunin charinya. In whole world, all are trying to have happiness. They want to be happy. For this, they try themselves or mixing with wife and husband, sometimes whole family, sometimes like Sanyukta Rashtra, Assembly of all the United Nations. They try, but they cannot check wash, they cannot check anything, because they are themselves having so many problems. If they have so many problems, how they can solve other problems? They cannot. So it is told that we are trying for happiness, but our sufferings are so strong. They come and they keep their fists on our head and forcibly. What? We'll have to test forcibly. We are bound to test them. Can you have any remedy to escape from old age? Never. From death? Never. So all want that I should be happy. But only wanting will do. All want. But all are dukhi, all are suffering. But it cannot be told that always they are unhappy and they have no a piece of happiness. Oh, they have. But that is happiness is like a very little, and at once they pass away. Again, second, always problems coming, suffering coming like waves. We say that, oh, this problem we will solve, and you will be happy. In the meantime, you are saying, oh, more bigger problem coming. So we are bound to this. Something coming from when you are married, at once you are seeing that, oh, at the day of marriage, oh, very beautiful, very beautiful. And next day we will see, she will want some ornaments and so many things. Or she will first control that you should not have anyone. If you have any girlfriend, you should. Oh, he cannot do. And so many problems comes. So, in this world there is no pure happiness. But we anyhow, we want pure happiness. And what is pure happiness? There is happiness, but not in this world. And that is called Brahmananda. What a jiva can taste in himself, if he can attain salvation, then he can taste Brahmananda. No distress at all. But Brahmananda is also not pure, not any affirmative, negative way. Like, what is negative? What negative? If a man has caught anyone and he was going to choke his, then he was crying, shame me, shame me, shame me. And he was about to die. And he was pushing. But anyone came and said to him. And then he stood up and, now I'm saved. So this is salvation and this is Brahmananda life. Not positive anything. But if you are serving Krishna, really, that is happiness. Otherwise, not. Krishna is embodiment of Ananda. I am Anandam, I am Brahma. If you are not following, serving, chanting, remembering Krishna, you cannot be happy in any way. So this is called not Brahma Ananda, this is called praying, love and affection to Krishna. And these are so many various of kinds. So, he wants happiness, but he does not know what is happiness. Really, this to serve Krishna and the love and affection of gopis, serving Krishna and they are having so much ananda, ananda pure. So, really we want like such love and affection, but we don't know what is that. But we want to happiness like such. Oh, if anyone wants to be happy, Krishna has transformed into Shastra. So in Shastra is written that if you will follow my instructions, you can have that kind of love and affection. So Shastra has told. And in all Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam is Amal Shastra, to whom you can rely and believe. He cannot cheat you, because Srimad Bhagavatam is the embodiment of Krishna himself. For in all Shastra, it has been written that if you will serve Krishna, then you will really be happy. If you are chanting, remembering Krishna, then by doing bhakti to Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna, Swayam Bhagavan Krishna, will be happy and then you must be happy. But Srimad Bhagavat was telling, he is telling some difference. What? Srimad Bhagavat is telling, O all jivas, you have no power, no, you have no qualification that you can serve Krishna. Never you can. You are like powerless. You cannot serve. You cannot call Krishna. Never you cannot call. All Shastra has told that you should remember and call Krishna. Harir Nam, Harir Nam, Harir Nam. Kalau Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva. It has told in Vishnu Purana or other Purana, not in Srimad Bhagavata. So all Shastra has told that you should do bhajan to Krishna. But Srimad Bhagavata, what is telling? Oh, you cannot call Krishna. Oh, Krishna is descending to call you. He is so merciful. Out of mercy, he has descended to this world. You cannot go there. Answer. Can you go to Vrindavan, Gokul, Navadvip, Dham there, Shradvip? You cannot go. You cannot call him. But Krishna is so, the Krishna of Srimad Bhagavatam is so merciful. He took his float. And he descended to this earth in Vrindavan. And he was calling to all. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, you should only hear from, you should give your ears. Only ear. Not, I don't want anything. Guru, the real Guru, qualified Guru, only tells, oh, give your ears to me. I don't want anything. Your wealth, your anything I don't want. I want your and I want to purify your ears. And by here I will give something in your heart that you will be happy forever. Transcendental happiness will come to you. Other, there is no other process to be happy. You are crying for Krishna, but your crying has no power. How your crying? I am giving an example. Our crying is like this. Oh, there was a very beautiful cross, very powerful cross. All the devotees were there. And those who were speaking Srimad Bhagavatam, telling Harikatha, he has so much ears. And also long ears. And it was quietly, it has become white. And he was telling like this and that. And his ears was. All were attentively hearing. And an old lady, oh, he was sitting there. And always weeping, weeping, weeping. Tears come. The Sadhu Baba who was speaking Harikatha, when it was finished the class, all went gracefully. And lady was there. He called that lady, oh mother, oh, you are a very high class of devotee. My what Harikatha touched your heart. And why you are weeping so bitterly? Then he again began to weep more and telling that, Baba, what to tell? I have a, what? Not Bakari, Bakari. Male goat. And he was so strong. And he has so much beard like you, just. Sometimes I used to give something to eat. And then he happily used to eat like this and that. So when you are telling Baba Harikatha, your yes, like my, I remember always my that goat, and anyone has just stolen away, what to do? I am waiting for that. So our calling to Krishna is like that. So, it may be some semblance, but not semblance, pratibimba.
Reflection.
Our arti should be pure. Oh, we cannot have that kind of arti. Arti means?
Sincere prayer.
Sincere prayer. With separation mode, from heart, core of heart. But Krishna has this. And that is why he descended. Oh, lakhs and lakhs, koti. More than us, he is weeping for us. Because he is father of father. Beloved of beloved. He has so much love and affection for us. Oh, they are suffering so much for getting me. They cannot come to me. They cannot even call me, weeping bitterly. Not hot milk. So I must go to them. And that is why he descended. With his flow, his all beauty, essence of the, all the beauty he took, and he came. And he is calling us. But we are not here. Try to realize this. Sarva bhuta manoharam ajak jagam kalau Bam disha manoharam. Oh, he took his flute and he was singing on cling and he was calling. But we cannot hear this sound also. We are not so much qualified. So we cannot go to Krishna and call. That is why Krishna came. Even in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, conjugal, both they can. Only to call us. And he went here and there, and he took sannyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu life. So Bhagavat is telling like this. Nidam kalpataror galitanga phalam sukham khad amrit dravasun bhudam ivat bhagavatam rasamalayam muhuraho rasika. Krishna became like fruit, nigam kalpataru fruit. No, nothing, only rasa. And he was brought by whom? Sukadeva Goswami in Guru Parampara. So, Krishna has descended to this world to call us. Why? Oh, don't be suffering. Be happy. Transcendental happiness you should have and to give. But we are not qualified even to this. We don't want to be transcendental happiness. Oh, Bhagavat is telling, Kangva Dayalum Sharanam Braja. He is asking to all others, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Mahabharata, Ramayana, to all. Srimad Bhagavat is questioning. Kangva Dayalum Sharanam Brajima. He is asking, but none is replying. And then Srimad Bhagavat himself, Oh Bakiyam Stanakal. Even a demon like Putana, always taking the flesh and new bloods of babies everywhere. So this demon and went to kill Krishna. And what Krishna did? He changed his cloth, he changed his body, and he sent to Vaikuntha, more than that. So we should try to serve Krishna and to hear Krishna. We should be qualified. How you can? Or throw any qualified devotee. Like guru, devotee, same thing. You cannot go. So all Shastra told that all human want happiness and they want to meet with Krishna. But Bhagavad tells what? Bhagavan wants Jeev. You know also that In all Shastra, it has been told that when Krishna went to Mathura and Gopi was feeling separation, then all Shastra are telling what? That Gopis sent any Hansa, swan, where? To Mathura, to tell their separation news, how they are suffering. But Srimad Bhagavata is telling another thing, what? Krishna was suffering so much. And he was suffering so much that he had to send his messenger. Understanding? Gopis are not sending, but Krishna is sending because he is so merciful. So merciful. So bhakti is so much katar for Bhagavan. Katar means? Always suffering, always weeping, separation, feeling separation, hankering. But Srimad Bhagavat was telling opposite. Krishna is hankering from his devotees. Always. Krishna always calling what? Oh mother, mother. And he is searching where my boyfriend are here. All Balbal. Brahma has taken them. And he is searching them. So Krishna is searching us, but we are so unqualified that we cannot hear his flow. We cannot call with our. So we should try. But you can only try when your heart is so empty and you have taken the shelter of any high class of devotees. Then Krishna has come and has gone to Mathura. Now in the beginning I told 5 or 6 questions. No? What questions? Braja, Vrindavan, Gokul, Mathura, Gokul and all other. Braja, Bhumi, is a place of so high class of love and affection. No? Vrindavan is itself Rasa. No? So why Krishna left Vrindavan and went to Mathura and to Dwarka? Why? Why?
He saw it as a duty, Maharaj.
So there is a question. That why Krishna? He is ocean of Rasa himself and Vrindavan is also ocean of Rasa. And even he left it. Secondly, if he went, if there was any cause, we go anywhere for any special reason, cause, and if cause is finished, we return. So if Krishna has left Vrindavan for any special reason, a special cause, that cause should be finished and he should return to Vrindavan. But he never returned. Oh. What is the answer of this? Anyone wants to live at a place where he receives so much love and affection. He doesn't want to taste any lower kind of love affection. Like if you are having a rasagolla, then if anyone giving you some good in India or anything, you cannot take it. You want to say rasagolla first. So why Krishna? Lover like gopis, Mother Jashoda, Nanda Baba and others. And quickly he left in a day and he never returned. Why? Third question. of his not coming forever. But he can come time to time. What harm? If anyone has gone, come to America from India to make some money, and if money is sufficient, and then he can return. If in case he is not returning, but he can go to India to meet his relatives, he may go. So Krishna, why not going to meet their relatives, his father and mother? He should go, but he is not going at all. Oh, today he is sending a messenger, but why not himself going? He is sending messenger. Messenger can do the same thing what Krishna can do. He knows that they will be not satisfied. They will only be satisfied if I am going there. But he is sending messenger and giving what? A letter to them that you should give this sandesh, this message to them. Or if there is so much heavy reason, cause, heavy means important cause or reason, that he cannot go, return to them. Then there is some way that he can call all the Brajavasi to Mathura or Dwarka. There is no lacking of any space, so much space. He can do anything. He can supply all houses and boarding and everything, as he gave, hosted all Mathura Vasi. So he can bring all, and he will be in Mathura, in Dwarka, he should be in Mathura. And with all Brajavasi, why he is not bringing them? Oh, if you want to know all the answers of all the questions, then you will have to go deep in Srimad Bhagavatam with any high class of devotees who has served his Gurudev, the devotees, and he has served Bhagavatam with Bhagavatam. What is meaning? He should serve Bhagavatam with Bhagavatam, because the key and lock is in the hands of Mahabhagavatam. Then we don't want to serve any Mahabhagavatam. We don't want to give honor to all, but we want that our all answers should be satisfied. Huh? How it can be? So Krishna is so merciful. He is sending his any kinds of devotees. Oh, go and tell some answers, so that there may be a devotee like this. Now you are coming to our questions, that answer, that it is to first questions and answer. Why he left? I told one reason of Prem Sarovar. Krishna is so worried that gopis went with me. They felt so much preparation mood for future, and they became like lifeless in Prem Vaijitya, in Mahabhav, in what? Prem Vaijitya Arika? Dibyonmar. You cannot imagine all these things. And feeling so much separation mood, burning in fire of separation. So Krishna wanted that if I am out of Vrindavan, they will feeling separation, and in separation mode they will meet me in dream even. in any way. They will see Tamal and they will embrace like Krishna, that, oh, direct, we are meeting with you. And then they will be happy. Or they will take something and they will
decorate
something. So I must be. Secondly, he is telling that it is true that anyone wants to be there where he is plenty of ananda, happiness. He don't want to go to any place where there is less happiness and less love and affection. But this is not the nature of Krishna, Supreme Personality of Krishna, Godhead. His nature is some different. What? He has lakhs and lakhs devotees everywhere. Also there are some devotees in Mathura, and they have been given so much sufferings by Kans, feeling so much. From when? Devaki and Vasudev are suffering from the very day when their marriage was going to hell. Krishna was there for about 10 years, 8 months in Braja. And from beginning of marriage, 8 sons were there with Krishna. So many years, and after that 10 years, 8 months more. How much years together?
About
19 years. 19 years. So many years. Yes, it may be. It may be like 20 years, it may be. And they were being suffered by Kansa. So many persons left Mathura. They scattered here and there. And those who were there were always weeping and suffering. So how Krishna can give up them? He cannot neglect. He should care. And if he is not taking care, then he is not merciful at all. Also Pandavas are weeping, Kunti is weeping for Krishna that he should come and help us. Draupadi calling him, oh, I am now becoming shameless. And she is calling bitterly. Oh, keeping his hands. Oh, Govinda, Raku Sarana, Abhata Jivana Hari. Now I am dying. What Krishna will do? If he is playing in Ras Leela, in Vrindavan, in Bansibat, what he will do? He will have to save also. Any bhakta in any fair in this world, and he is calling Krishna. Krishna cannot remain. Otherwise, he will have to give up his name that you are Bhakta Vatsal. You are merciful. So he will have to take care of all. And that is why he was testing so much rush in Vrindavan. But also he will have to look after all the devotees. So there are so many devotees in Mathura, here and there. He should also hear their call. That is why Krishna also went there no home. But something more. Because Krishna has promised, Je jathang mam prapadyante tam tathayo bhajamaham. Those who are serving me, I will have to repay them in the same way. But only there are gopi that he could not keep his promise. He failed to keep his promise. For all he can keep his promise, but for gopis nothing. So, it is sure that there is no comparison of whole world's any devotees like Brajavasi. Anyone cannot compare. Like Jashoda mother, like Sudal Subhan or others, like Gopis, Lalita Vishakha and all others. Oh, there is no comparison. But Devaki and Vasudev, they have also did stories, very hard stories in their past. But you know, keeping their head down, standing on one here and taking their feet high, without any air, water, in hot day, in winter season, rainy season, always. How much? More than 60,000 years. Dhruva has done only, how much? 6 months without air. And he, more than 60,000 years. And now he is calling in the form of Vasudeva and Devaki. Will he not hear? He must hear. This was also a reason to come to Mathura. Now, second thing, if Krishna finished his that cause, he came to save his father, mother, and he saved and he killed Kans. So he came to kill Krishna, Kansa, and he finished this cause, then he must return to Vrindavan. But how he can? All the Jadvasi, Mathuravasi has escorted here and there for the fear of. So his whole kingdom was like Vishrinkal. Vishrinkal means? It was not in order. So Krishna gave the kingdom to Ugrasen Maharaj. He made him king. But he was so much old, powerless person. Krishna should manage. So he was managing. And if he not managing, that what will be? Oh, there were two wives of Kans, Asti and Prapti. They went to hit their father, Jarasandha. He was very big demon, like. Very powerful, more than Kans and all others, Duryodhana and all. And when he heard that, oh, his son-in-law has been killed by Krishna, and he was innocent, oh, already innocent. And this Krishna killed him. He was sitting on the throne, only, and they jumped and took his, and without any reason, and they killed. He became so unhappy, serious. And he took his soldiers, more than Mahabharata soldiers, army, so much army. 20 lakhs or crores of army he took, and he invaded at 18 times, not only time, 18 times. So Krishna knows that if I am going to Braja, then what happened? All will be killed by Jarasandha. So he cannot go. Can he go? If he goes to Vrindavan time to time, that what will become? Krishna wanted to go time to time. But if Jarasandha will know that really, oh, all the Brajvasi are so beloved, so dear to Krishna, so I will mash Vrindavan. There are no soldiers, no army, no killa, fort, nothing. And they are not warriors, all wolves. Only grazing cow, very innocent. So in one day, Jarasandha will come and smash whole Vrindavan. But Nanda Baba knows this. So Krishna told in his ears, don't be restless. I will come after finishing Jarasandha and all, and I will come. So So I must come. But if I am not coming, time to time that Kansa will, they will know and they will attack whole Brijbhas. And then everything will be finished. I cannot save him. There is no fort, no army, nothing. So he is not coming. And more things. One thing. Anyone goes to anywhere for any job or any what duty. Vasudev knows this very clearly, Vasudev and Devaki, that Krishna has come from Vrindavan. And if Krishna returns to Vrindavan, he will never come. If anyone goes to anywhere. And Krishna tells that I am going to Indraprastha, I am going to Mithila, or I am going here and there. They will know, never object. That you should go and very quickly you should return. But if Krishna wants any permission from Devaki and Vasudev, that I want to go quickly to Vrindavan and I will return. Then they become very worried and they began to weep, nothing telling anything, not giving permission. Why not? That Vrindavan is a Rasamayi Bhumi. He is not going to finish any karma or any job or anything. And he will go and he will be totally absorbed in rasa. Because Vrindavan is rasa bhumi. Krishna is himself rasa. All the gopis and gopis are rasa. So this is not a job, not a duty, not a anything. So he will not return. So when Krishna anyhow tells that may I go, they began to be bitterly. Not only Devaki was there, whole Mathurabhasi began to weep that we will die today. What Krishna should do? That is why. Or sometimes he wants to go but cannot go. These are the reasons. Also, if he is going there sometimes and only meeting with them and he can return, because Vrindavan is only two fingers far away from Vrindavan, Mathura, only. And the place is what? Borderline. Only Mathura and Vrindavan, so nearer. He can go to Golok Vrindavan, he can go to Mithila, he can go to Dwarka in a moment. And why he cannot come in hour, 2 hours, he can come to Vrindavan. But he is not coming. Why? Because if he is going for a moment, then what becomes? The separation mode of gopis and gopis will go less and less time more. More and more. It will not subside, but it will increase so much. Why? If there is a lamp, the lamp of what? Lamp mein kya hota hai?
Flame.
If there is a flame in lamp, if there is a little air, it can be extinguished. It can be subsided. But if the fire is so in so big, like forest fire, can it be subsided by any air, or what it will be?
More intense.
more increasing. So, the suppression fire of gopis and gops, motorized like this. It is not like a very pradeep that it will be subsided. Like, if you can put any sign pen on a stove and it is like a radish and give one
drop of water,
what it will be? And if it will touch your anywhere, you will be burned. So Vrindavan, fire, this separation mood is like this. If Krishna goes for a moment, for one day, 2 days, it will go so high that they will die at once. So he is not going with fear. Something also, if anyone questioning that Krishna should bring his father, mother, all the gopis, Sakha and all to Mathura, oh, there is very broad place. He can bring them. Why he not bring him? Oh, there is something danger. What danger? Rasa Sankata. Rasa Sankata mane? There is Sankata of Rasa mane?
Danger
of exchanging of Rasa. What is that?
Contradiction of mellow.
Contradiction of mellow there. What? In Vrindavan, Krishna is like a cowherd boy, only son of Nanda Baba, without shoes and without umbrella, and serving all the cows, serving Nanda Baba Yashoda. And in Mathura, he is a Kshatriya king, very powerful. No flute, no steel, not cowherd boy, like a king. And what kind of king? Oh, he is samrat. What? Emperor. Emperor here. No one can challenge him there. But in Vrindavan, if he come, all Brajavasi comes, then can he keep his peacock feather here? And his float on his ear, and like what he will tell? If Nanda Baba comes, then to whom he will tell father and mother? To Devaki Basudeva or Nanda Baba? And to whom in night he will be? Will gopis or Satyabhama Rukmini? There will be fight against each other. Also, in Mathura, he is Paradevata. Paradevata ki Srimad Bhagavatam tau. Paradevateti. He is Paradevata of all the Jadavas. Paradevata means?
Vishnu-nam Paradevateti.
Vishnu-nam. Jadav. He is king of kings and he is worshipable of all the Mathura-vasi. But in Vrindavan, what is? Swajan, only son of Nanda Baba. Oh, he is only friend of, beloved of gopis only, not Paradevata. Any gop will not worship Krishna. Yashoda Maiya never worship. Any gopis, they can worship with what? Abuses, kala, black, like what? More. Lampata, chur, thief, black-hearted, oh, these are their worshipping. If all gopis will go and abuse like they are in Mathura, then what will happen in front of all the Jadavas? What will be there? No solution at all. Then, his worshipable of all the Jadavas. Even to Uddhav, Akrur, King Ugrasen, and all to all. But here, any Siddham Subal will climb upon his what? And he will, oh, my horse, gone. And he will tell to Krishna, oh, quickly run. And there, if Siddham Subal are going in Mathura, and they will make Krishna like horses, and in the front of all the Jadavas, what will be there? Can they tolerate? That's the big problem. Oh, there, Devaki even, and Father Vasudev, they cannot take the pranam of Krishna. Why? Oh, Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. They fear. They have seen 400. But here, in Vrindavan, oh, Nandva Baltan, oh, bring my soup, my paduka, and Krishna will take on head, and dancing will come. If Nanda Baba is there telling, oh, my son, oh, you should bring my jyoti in Mathura, and in front of all Jadavar, what Krishna will do? Will he bring? Then he will be in confusion what to do. Moreover, when Krishna is with all the gopis, Lalita, Vishakhar, and all others, can he sit with Radhika and make rash there in Mathura in front of all Jadus? Can he massage the feet of Radhika in front of them? So this is what? Rasmaya Satruta? Contradiction in manners. How Krishna can reconcile all these things? So he is in dilemma and he is not bringing anyone. Gaur Premana. Dut wala kyun bhaja? Oh, isliye. Now, Krishna is thinking, why should I, he sent Uddhava. I told you that in these circumstances Krishna cannot go there. Then if he sends his messengers to pacify their father and mother, sometimes, then he can know something. And this most important thing is that he is sending Uddhava to be admitted in the school of gopis, where Lalita Vishakhar are teachers and Srimati Radhika himself, principal life. And Uddhava should be admitted. And he should learn all these things. He can learn, but cannot realize. Anyhow, he should go and be admitted, and he should know only 2.5 letters. He cannot know all swar and vyanjan. Never he cannot. Of Vrindavan. Only he should read what? 2.5 letters. Prema. In English, no word like this. If labha, then it will be 4. So, praying. So he sent him. He should learn something about prem, and when he will be qualified, he should come so that I can give my some sufferings to him. So this messenger should be sent. Not messenger, but to be qualified. To know what is love and prem of Braja Prem, and he will realize something. He cannot realize more, but something he will realize. And then he will return, I can weep, and then he will realize that why I am weeping, why I am suffering this. Then I can distribute my sum of sufferings to him. Gaur Premananda.
Krishna is having his devotees all over. And if he will keep on going there and then Brajavasi will never have
time. Never. Don't jump, please. You cannot understand. It is in Sanskrit.
I am saying that if Krishna will keep on going to wipe the tears of different devotees, then Brijvasi will have never their turn for Krishna. And they will always
He has made this turn, so again he will make turn. And he is Golok Vrindavan, Aprakat Leela, he has so many things. So we should begin from beginning. Baku vegam manasa krodha vegam jihva vegam udharo pasna vegam etan vegan jyapi sarethe sarvam apimam patri sasya dadati pratigrahnati ujjyam alkati and so many. Then tannam rupa charita desu kirtana kramena rasana manasi tishthan praje tadanuragi But now I am saying that all not doing that. A little bit also. We have so many books.
We need your support, Maharaj. We need a general behind us.
Oh, the, you should. I am requesting to all the devotees that they should at least in 1 year, at least 12 books, they should distribute. At least 12 books, and easily you can do. 1 book, 1 month, I'm thinking sufficient. But I know that at the time of your Prabhupada, how many? Lakhs and lakhs books. So I think that you must take at least 12 books, more than 2, and I will have to reward them. If among them who will distribute some best distributor. So you should try to do this and that.
Please send this in email everywhere. Yes.
And the assembled Vaishnavas, we humbly offer a dramatic presentation of part 1 of the Sri Brihad Bhagavatamrita by Srila Sanatana Goswami. Once, at the holy place of Prayag, many exalted munis completed their morning bath and sat down near the deity of Sri Madhava. The Brahmana king of that land, accompanied by his entourage, came there, and with great respect and devotion, he worshipped Sri Shalagram Shila, and then satisfied all the munis with Mahaprasad. Sri Narada Muni, who had observed his activities from a distance, stood up in the assembly of sages and said, "This Brahmana is very dear to Bhagavan Mahavishnu." Then, Sri Narada, who is expert in relishing the mellows of Bhagavad Bhakti, in order to proclaim to the world the glories of the greatest recipients of Sri Krishna's mercy, began to glorify the king. But the king humbly rejected that praise and send Sri Narada to another king in South India. However, that king also did not consider himself to be a great object of Sri Bhagavan's mercy and sent Narada to Lord Indra. Indra sent him to Brahma, and Brahma sent him to Shiva. In this way, Sri Narada wandered throughout the universe, searching for the greatest recipient of Sri Krishna's mercy. In his travels, he also took darshan of Prahlad Maharaj, Hanuman, the Pandavas, and finally, the residents of Dwarka. Hearing from the Yadavas the glory of Sri Uddhava, Narada became immersed in the ras of Mahaprem and forgot everything, even playing the veena, which he held in his hand. Appearing like a man possessed by ghosts, he walked along the magnificent path leading to Sri Krishna's residence. Sometimes he danced, sometimes he fell to the ground, sometimes he cried out in ecstasy, and sometimes he cried in a distressed voice. He exhibited all the symptoms of ecstatic love simultaneously. On that day, Sri Krishna was despondent for some reason and was still sleeping in his bedroom. Sri Uddhava was seated near the doorway, along with Baldev Prabhu, Sri Devaki Ji, Sri Rohini Ji, Sri Rukmini Devi, Sri Satyabhama Devi, and all of Krishna's queens, along with Kamsa's inimical mother, Padmavati.
Truthful. O best of the great Munis, whatever you speak is certainly true. I know this to be a fact. But when I recently went to Vrindavan, I experienced something which pulverized my pride for my own good fortune. From this, I came to understand the wonderful sweetness of Sri Krishna, his mercy, his pastimes, and his beloved devotees. Upon receiving the darshan of the Brajbasis, I considered myself most fortunate. What I repeatedly sang after going there, expressing my desire to take birth there as a blade of grass, is well known to everyone. O best of sages, humbly bowing down, I implore you not to desire to hear that narration, which is saturated with wrath. First, because Sri Rukmini, Satyabhama, and others are nearby. And secondly, because if Sri Shyam Sundar himself hears it, will be overwhelmed in Rajputana. Dear Uddhava, best of those known as Haridas, there is no need to say more. Please, don't revive the memory of the Brajvasis. By forgetting this memory, I have finally experienced some momentary happiness. When Sri Vasudev brought me here from Braj, Yasoda Devi cried so bitterly that it melted stone and shattered thunderbolts. When Sri Krishna returned from the ashram of his guru, like a fool, I briefly and sadly narrated the plight of the Brajvasis to him. But it did not melt his heart, even a little, so he did not go there. Knowing you to be expert in delivering clever messages, he sent you instead. Please listen to what I saw with my own eyes. Since Krishna arrived in Vrindavan, from the repeated attacks of demons, serpents, and other fearsome creatures, what calamity meant to destroy Braj did not occur. Still, the Brajvasis never minded, being enchanted by the sweetness of Sri Krishna. They were solely for his welfare, without a thought of their own. Due to their natural love, everything they did was exclusively for the pleasure of Sri Nandanandana. Even then, Krishna did not do anything for them. So what can I say about now? Being immensely unfortunate, the Brajvasis are submerged in an ocean of anguish. Why then do you say that they are the greatest object of your master's mercy?
Alas, from childhood, Krishna was made to take the cows of those merciless cowherd men out to graze in a forest of brambles. Can you believe they didn't even give him shoes to wear? And when tortured by hunger, eating just a little butter, the cowherd women used to tie him up. And those cowherd women used to constantly shout accusations at him. So tell me, what more could he possibly do for them?
After killing all the Yadava's enemies, Sri Krishna ruled their capital Mathura, and now he happily resides in Dwarka as the King of Kings. It is very unfortunate that your master does not even remember the Brajvasis.
Hey, Mother Rohini, how can you speak such words? Don't you know that his heart is softer than butter? Otherwise, he would not be speaking this way. Sometimes, when he sleeps at night, he lovingly calls out the names of many cows. Sometimes, he calls out the name of many cowherd boyfriends, and he assumes an enchanting threefold bending pose as he plays the flute. Sometimes he calls to me, "Hey mother, give me some butter." And sometimes he calls to me, "Hey Rade, hey Lalite, hey Chandravali." Sometimes he sheds so many tears of love,
Mama,
that it drenches his pillow. Seeing his sorrow, we are simply plunged in an ocean of sorrow. Last night, while he slept, he had a dream which has made him depressed. He merely cries in anguish, covering his lotus face with a cloth. He lies there motionless, as if sleeping, and he has not performed any of his daily duties.
Why do you utter such nonsense? Say that he only becomes like this at night. Even when he is awake, he is dazed and behaves just as he does when he is sleeping. We are as wise in name only. In reality, even the dasis of the Raj Gopis are more dear to him than we are.
Dasis. Because we are all engaged in conversing about the plight of the Raj Vasis, my brother Krishna is simply exhibiting his expertise in cheating by pretending to be afflicted. In an effort to console them, I went to Raj and stayed there for 2 months. But neither my words nor actions would pacify them, seeing that they would not be pacified without Krishna himself coming. I made them so many promises that appeased them somewhat. And on the pretext of quickly returning with my brother Krishna, with great difficulty I returned here. Arriving here, I fretfully said to Krishna, on any pretext, go to Vraj just once and save the lives of the residents there. His mouth replied, I am going just now. But the thought of it never reached his heart, because you can understand a person's heart by their actions.
Oh, what you have said is true. Although struck by a great thunderbolt, my heart does not shatter. I have forgotten their extraordinary love for me and how they nurtured me for so long in my childhood. What to speak of being even a little benevolent towards them? Instead, I have been cruel and caused immense suffering to their soft hearts. Hey, Brother Uddhava, you know, you are most dear to me. Tell me at once, what should I do? Quickly, deliver me from this ocean of anguish.
Oh, Krishna, you should give your dear friends in Vraj whatever they desire.
Oh, Krishna, why are you feeling such remorse? Please, listen to my advice. Sri Gargacharya will calculate every morsel of food that you two brothers ate while living with Nanda Maharaj for those 11 years. And my husband will give them twice that amount. I swear it. And then, according to his discretion, Nanda Maharaj will decide whether he wishes to reimburse you for looking after the cows during that time.
Oh, best of scholars, you know all the aspirations of the Vrajvasis. Tell me at once, what do they wish of me?
The Vrajvasis do not desire the opulence of kings, the celestial possessions of the residents of Swarga, or anything of this world. They only want you. Please be merciful and listen carefully to what I am saying, and you may decide for yourself what should be done. Previously, when the Vrajvasis saw the clothes and ornaments which you sent back with Sri Nanda, they were plunged into an ocean of grief and said to one another, it is our great misfortune that Sri Krishna thinks that we desire these things and that giving them to us is his mercy. Then Sri Yashoda, then all the Vrajvasis, thinking that you were not returning, began fasting until death. Sri Nanda, thinking he had committed an offense, became anguished and could not speak for 3 days. Then he concluded that the Vrajvasis were certainly going to perish. So hundreds of times he repeated your promise that you would be returning soon. He told them, my son Krishna sent these articles as indications of his love for you. He is true to his word. He will return soon. But when you did not go there and sent me with a message, all the Vrajvasis became as if dead. My lord, I am unqualified to speak of their love for you. To attain you, the Vrajvasis have given up everything. And to know what their condition is now, ask your elder brother.
My dearest ones, after completing my remaining duties and comforting my friends here, I will quickly return.
Prabhu, understand this to be certain. Without the auspicious return of your lotus feet, the Vrajvasis will certainly perish. They do not desire anything but you.
Oh, foolish Devaki. Now, yes, now I've understood. Those cunning coward men have bewitched Uddhava by incessantly feeding him milk. And now, with his help, they wish to take your son back to that dangerous, inaccessible forest, which is inhabited by wild beasts, just to protect their domestic animals.
Hey, Mother of Kamsa,
what is this about Krishna being exploited to protect the cows? In Braj, there is no danger of the cows being killed or stolen, so there is no need for them to have protection. In the morning, the cows voluntarily go to the forest to eat the plentiful grass to their heart's content, and automatically return to their homes in the evening. In reality, On the pretext of taking the cows to graze, Sri Krishna regularly entered those charming forests with his elder brother and cowherd friends, just to enjoy many pastimes there. When Sri Krishna would take the cows out, in separation from him, the Brajvasis considered the day to be as long as Brahma's night, and each moment to be like a yuga. Time and again, they looked at the path by which he would return, at the sun for indications of when it would set, and for signs of dust being raised by the calf's hooves. And when the vibration of his flute was heard, they entered into a state of maddened praying.
Oh, garrulous child, if that is so, then tell us, why have we now heard that for want of protection, all the cows are nearly dead?
Oh, Krishna, but to speak of just the cows, your beloved deer and birds, trees, vines, and creepers, also the kunjas and grass, have given up their lives for your sake. Hey, brother, sustained by your promise and hopeful of receiving your darshan again, only a few Vrajvasis remain alive. You don't want to hear any more. If you are not kind to them now, then Yamaraj will certainly devour them all. Please, it is a matter of great sorrow to them that you removed the poison from Kaliagat, because otherwise they would have been able to give up their lives by drinking it. Please hear another cause of grief. The Yamuna has very little water remaining. It is almost completely dry. Thus they are unable to drown themselves in it. Giriraj Govardhan, which you held with your lotus hand, has shrunk. Thus they are unable to give up their lives by jumping from the top of it. The Vrajvasis have given up eating it and drinking altogether. But because they still drink the nectar of your name, their lives do not leave them. Now their only destination is to be consumed by fire in that dry forest.
Seeing this unprecedented spectacle of anguished crying, Rohini, Uddhava, Rukmini Devi, Satyabhama Devi, and all the residents of the inner chambers became grief-stricken and cried out again and again. Hearing the sounds of weeping and distress, Sri Vasudeva, Sri Ugrasena, and all the Yadavas quickly ran there. Seeing the condition of Sri Krishna and Sri Balaram, they became devastated and cried loudly. And when Gargacharya, the Brahmanas, and all the residents of the city came, they also cried in the same way. At once, the vibration of weeping of Sri Krishna and his associates pervaded the entire universe, giving birth to numerous calamities. Knowing that no one besides Sri Krishna could restore peace to the universe, Lord Brahma came there with his associates. Seeing that Mahanarayan Sri Krishna, tormented by love for his dearest devotees, had fallen into an unprecedented condition, he could understand that the Lord was now anxious to manifest the hidden glories of the sweetness of his devotees' prema for him. Carefully composing himself, Brahma called Garuda and told him, "Nearby, between Mount Raivata and the ocean, Vishvakarma constructed a Sri Vrindavan, which is adorned with murtis of Sri Nanda, Yashoda, the residents of Braja, and many cows. It is so splendorous that it seems to be the Sri Vrindavan which is situated in Mathura Mandala. While Sri Krishna and Baladev are in this condition, please carefully take them there. Take Rohini Devi also, but no one else." Then, Brahmaji helped the residents of Dwarka to regain their composure and sent them to their own places. Unable to leave Krishna while he was in that unconscious state, Uddhava, Devaki, and the queens headed by Rukmini and Satyabhama and Padmavati also went there. But at the request of Brahma, they stood at a distance and watched from a hidden position. Considering himself an offender due to having made Sri Krishna faint, Narada did not enter there. Instead, attired like a yogi, he remained hidden in the sky from where he could witness the sweetness of Bhagavan's lila. Then, Sri Baladev regained consciousness and understood Brahmaji's intention. He wiped Sri Krishna's as well as his own lotus face, gently placed a garland of kadamba flowers around his neck, a flute in his lotus hands, and a peacock feather in his crown.
Wake up and see, it is late. The cows have already left for the forest. And overcome with affection, your parents cannot even speak. Hey, Krishna, get up.
Hey, Mother. This morning I have seen many peculiar dreams, which all seem so real. I went to Mathura and killed Kamsa. I had a great palace named Dwarka constructed on the shore of the ocean. And I cannot quickly describe to you all the rest. Due to these long, enchanting dreams, which seemed like ages, I was unable to rise at the usual time. Hey, brother, if you will not consider a lie, when we go to the forest, I will tell you in detail about these highly astonishing dreams.
Oh, child. Because you are her only son, today your mother is very worried because you slept so long. Your cows and sakas have gone far ahead. You should quickly follow them to the forest. I will prepare your lunch and send it.
Thank you, Mother. Please send them to Daniel. Oh, queen of my life. Why do you not speak? Are you feeling jealous today? Knowing everything, you have ascertained what I saw in my dreams. Yes, now I understand. You must know that I left you, went to another place, and married many princesses. But please, listen to the reason for it. They were extremely anxious to get married. And if I had not fulfilled their desires, they would have certainly perished. I also had many children and grandchildren. What has happened, happened. Now I must quickly proceed to the forest. Tonight we shall meet again.
When Devaki saw Sri Krishna going along, playing his flute, and dressed in his enchanting forest attire, none of which she had ever seen before, out of love, milk began to flow from her breasts. Seeing him like this for the first time, the queens, headed by Rukmini and Jambavati, became bewildered by Mahaprema and fainted. Overcome with amorous desire, Satyabhama and old Padmavati tried to run after Krishna to embrace him. But Sri Kalindi, who had seen Krishna like this before, carefully kept her composure, and along with Sri Uddhava, forcibly pulled them back.
Oh, Sakas, where have you gone? Hey, Sridham, Subal, come to the bank of the Yamuna. The cows can drink the pure sweet water. And then we will enjoy water sports. What is this? Where am I? Who
understand who you are. Beseeched by the demigods, you have descended to remove the earth's burden. Therefore, please annihilate the demons, protect the saintly persons, and perform the sacrifice of your cousin. You made Yudhisthira the emperor, and by your prowess, you frightened the demons headed by Anusalva. Now please take the Yadavas there and kill those who, out of enmity for you, torment your devotees.
Hearing these words of Sri Baladev, which were meant to help him regain his composure and bring him to a different ras, that of heroism, Sri Krishna's mood changed. Due to having become aware of this topic, he abandoned his previous state of being spellbound in separation. Then Krishna saw the flute in his hand and remembered that he had just left his home to take the cows out to graze. Thus he became simultaneously wonderstruck and doubtful and began laughing. Then Sri Baladev smiled and told him how and why Brahmaji had arranged everything.
Hey, brother! Who is this demoniac younger brother of Solva? Alone, I will go there now and kill him.
Sri Baladev Prabhu then cleansed the dust from Sri Krishna's limbs and had him bathe in the ocean. Then Garuda came there and brought Krishna back to his palace. Sri Uddhava, Rukmini Devi, and the other queens, but having come back to consciousness, returned to the inner chambers of Sri Krishna's residence.
Upon witnessing this bhav from a distance, a senile and wicked Padmavati said, O impious Devaki, O unfortunate Rukmini, O lonely queens headed by Satyabhama, seeing this, you must now surely renounce your pride and perform austerities to take birth and become maidservants of the cowherd girls. Hearing these words, Sri Devaki replied, O half-witted Padmavati, what is so astonishing about this? In our previous lives, Vasudeva and I performed austerities to attain Sri Bhagavan as our son. But Nanda and Yashoda prayed for Krishna Bhakti and to love Krishna as their son. Therefore, it is most proper that he has this type of bhav towards them, and that bhav is also dear to me. Then Sri Rukmini joyfully said, the gopis' prema is superior to ours, because although we are fortunate enough to be his wives, we are engaged in activities relating to our dharma, karma, children in homes, and we serve him with awareness of his majesty and opulence, whereas the gopis serve him solely and with pure bhav. To attain Krishna, they have abandoned everything, even their husbands, and they are indifferent to the pleasures of this world or the next. Therefore, we should not be envious of them. Rather, we should praise that bhav which brings Sri Krishna under the control of his devotees. All the other queens approved of these words, but Sri Satyabhama could not tolerate them and fled to the chamber of jealous love.
Bring that foolish princess here at once. Oh, narrow-minded daughter of Satyajit, just as you have become jealous many times before, such as when Rukmini received the Parijata flower, now you are jealous upon seeing the pinnacle of prema which the Vrajvasis possess for me. If I were to go there now, I do not see that it would be for their welfare. Upon seeing me, their intense love would overflow, and in great distress, they would become spellbound. not to speak of forgetting their bodies. They would forget their very selves. Their suffering would not be lessened on seeing me. Even whatever activities I could perform for their happiness would merely double their agony, because they would be in constant fear of being separated from me again. Indeed, I am not able to repay my debt to them, and therefore I am a great debtor. Not seeing me now, sometimes being afflicted by the burning fire of separation, they become like corpses, and sometimes, being maddened, they experience various sweet bobs. Oh, proud and jealous girl, when I separated from the Braj Gopis, I had no desire to marry. But when, from the hand of a Brahmana, I received a pathetic letter saying that if I did not accept her, she would give up her life, I snatched her away from those wicked kings. When, from seeing her, intense remembrance of the gopis comes to me, I become anguished. Hey, Satyabhama, I thought that by marrying all of you, who are similar in number to the Braj gopis, my heart would be somewhat pacified. But know for certain that my great happiness and glory have not accompanied me here. Abandoning me, they have both remained in Braj, which is the only qualified place for them. Alas, it is very regrettable that not only are the blissful pastimes which I enjoyed there not possible here, I cannot even describe them.
That by continuing to glorify the Brajavasis in this way, Sri Krishna would again be overwhelmed by that bhav. Sri Uddhava inspired the queens to come closer by giving a hand signal. Then Rukmini Devi, along with Satyabhama Devi and all the queens, grasped Sri Krishna's lotus feet, and offering sincere prayers while shedding tears, gradually pacified their husband.
My dear Narada,